guys. I'm Jenny Mitchell. I'm one of the junior instructors here at KAATARO Jiu-Jitsu. I like to teach. I've gotten the opportunity to teach in my profession as a physical therapist, and I enjoy teaching here at KAATARO Jiu-Jitsu as well. It started off pretty small. When I first joined KAATARO Jiu-Jitsu, I think there was maybe three junior instructors. Three, maybe four. But they didn't really have an opportunity to teach other than just getting paired up with, you know, individuals, you know, during a class. You know, and then Ryan kind of ramped up the program when a couple of more of us got blue belts. And it's just been really cool just to be able to pass along the knowledge that Ryan has given us and that Dave gave Ryan. So
what was it like in the early days, you know, learning instructor stuff? It's kind of Wild West or what?
Yeah, not really. It was good. You know, like I think we had one meeting, where a couple of us couldn't go and a couple of us could go just cause it was in the middle of a day. And it was just kind of talking about curriculum, and Ryan had started to put together kind of a notebook, just a kind of a rough drawing, if you will, of what he wanted to teach the white belts. And in the beginning, all of the junior instructors were blue belts. You know, we didn't have any purple belts, no brown belts. It was just Ryan, the black belt, and us. You know, and then he would have a time slot every Sunday morning that we could go to his house, just the instructors, you know, and he would let us know, you know, if it was on that week, and we would go and we could ask any questions we wanted, you know, about teaching. You know, and also work stuff out on our own, you know, for our own jiu-jitsu game. You know, and the first time I got to teach was because Ryan was out of town for a couple of weeks, and we all kind of rotated through, you know, just trying to cover classes. And of course, I felt very inadequate to do that, but it was a great experience. So we kind of team taught, like there were at least two blue belts per class so that we could kind of team up and do it. So it was a lot of fun, a little scary, but a lot of fun. So right now I teach the fundamentals class. I teach that twice a week, and then I have another class. But just teaching the fundamentals, I mean, I go over and over and over the basic stuff, you know, because that's what we do in fundamentals. And anytime we get somebody brand new, you know, they come to my class. And so it has really, you know, I feel like solidified a lot of the escapes, you know, especially the defense in my game and in my mind. You know, I'm always going to run into somebody that's bigger, stronger than me, and it's going to be harder to escape. But I know the fundamental, the basic escape really well, just because I've had to teach it so many times. So I feel like that's really been super helpful, for my game in jiu-jitsu. As an instructor, you know, and Ryan said it himself, at one of our last meetings that we had, you know, he tries to make himself available to us as instructors. He wants to pour into us, if you will, so that we can then pass along Hickson's legacy, Dave Kama's legacy, the very best that we can. You know, the instructor training program is basically Ryan giving us as instructors his time, answering our questions, helping us to be able to pass along all of this information and knowledge as best as we possibly can, and as consistently as we possibly can.
You're held to a higher standard, but you're also given more opportunities, maybe?
Absolutely, yeah. You know, and I know, you know, Ryan's a very busy person, so we all greatly appreciate the time that he provides us. And he, on a weekly basis, I know he tries to provide that Sunday, you know, opportunity for us to, you know, come train and ask him questions. And if we can't make it to that, you know, during the week, I know, you know, I'm always free to ask him questions, and he's great at taking the time to answer whatever questions I have. One of the criteria, like, Ryan doesn't pick the instructors and ask them to be an instructor. And like, if we're interested in doing it, we have to go to him and ask him if we can be an instructor, which I found kind of funny, you know, like, what does he do? Tell him no or yes, or, you know, but anyway, it's been really good. And, you know, Dave Kama as well, when he's in town, he recognizes, you know, if we need to brush up on a certain concept or whatever, he'll help the instructors with that. And I know one of our purple belts, that's an instructor, Ken, he just opened up a school in Austin for Kama Jiu-Jitsu. So he's running that school. And I know Ryan and Dave, are working hard to make sure he's, you know, staying up with everything, because he's out there by himself right now. So, just like you said, it's a little extra attention, but, you know, I think it's great. We all love doing it, so. I'm sure Ryan has his list of things that he wants in an instructor, but I don't know what that is. But I know you do have to have at least a blue belt. There's no white belt instructors. And I think you got to be able to convey the information. You know, it's one thing to be able to train jiu-jitsu and be really good at it and tap everybody. It's another thing to be able to explain what you're doing. I found that out myself, you know, just doing jiu-jitsu. I'm like, you know, because people are like, well, what are you doing there? You didn't tell me that part. And it's, oh, okay. You know, like stuff that you just kind of intuitively do, but you forget to explain it. So just realizing that, has been really good for me, you know, so you got to be able to convey the knowledge that you have, and you gotta also, you know, one of the things that Ryan has always told us, you gotta be able to teach all different kinds of people. You know, everybody learns a little bit differently. Some people are kinesthetic learners. Some people, you know, learn by just listening. Some people learn by just watching. Everybody learns a little bit differently. And so you gotta be able to convey the information to everybody in a way that they will understand it. And, you know, figure out creative ways to do that for people. So I don't know much about Dave's instructor program, but I do see, you know, like how he and Greg interact. Greg is one of the brown belts there, and I know he teaches a class. And I've also, you know, Fernando, who he's a black belt in California under Dave, and he's taught me before too. Everybody has their, you know, and there's Jack Toffer and, you know, all these guys that learned under Dave and that are now instructors for him in California. And everybody's a little bit different in how they teach. I'm not quite sure, like, if Dave, you know, does the Sunday, you know, hey, you guys got questions for all the instructors, that sort of thing. But I do know that the level of teaching that they provide is excellent as well. Like, I always learn something amazing from all those guys. And Dave and Ryan, their teaching style is different, but it's excellent. Both of them are excellent teachers. So one thing, we were all the instructors were meeting just recently, and Dave Kama was in the room, and we're talking about our kids program. We're trying to make some changes and, make things better for the kids program. And Dave made a comment. He said, you know, little kids are really hard to teach, but if you can teach little kids, you can teach adults. I kind of chuckled at that. We all kind of did, but he's right. You know, if you can make information, you know, learnable for a young kid, you know, a 5-year-old kid and an older or a teenager, they're hard to. But if you can make things, you know, easy to learn for them, then you can definitely teach most adults. And I really took that to heart because he's right. You know, I've worked with kids before in a different capacity. But if you have the patience and can, help a kid learn something, then you can probably translate that into helping an adult learn something. So I thought that was a really, really good piece of advice from Dave. I think a teaching program is good for that because, like I said, you know, before, it's one thing to be able to be a really good jiu-jitsu practitioner, and to be able to submit everybody and, you know, train hard and do well. It's a whole nother thing to be able to explain jiu-jitsu, you know, and walk people through different movements and different techniques and different submissions and escapes. That's a whole nother deal. There's people that are incredible jiu-jitsu practitioners, but they have a really hard time explaining things. And then there's other people that, you know, they might get tapped frequently, but they can explain things to you really well. And they can see, you know, if they're watching somebody, they can tell, okay, yeah, that went wrong. Okay, we need to fix that. So I think it is good to have an instructor program to where you can help people if they're kind of on the edge of being a really good teacher and they just need a few cues. I think it's great for that. I do enjoy being a teacher at Kama Jiu-Jitsu. It has it's been really neat to see people do well. You know, like, and I can say, yeah, I got to teach them that. And it's also really helped, again, it's helped my game quite a bit. Just the repetition of teaching, especially the fundamentals, has been really good for me. You know, and it also makes me kind of up my game. Okay, if I'm teaching people this, then I best be able to execute it myself. So that's been a good discipline for me. And I encourage you guys, you know, you guys know, if you have a passion for teaching, if you like to teach just in general, and you're good at jiu-jitsu too, then, you know, if you're here at Common Jiu-Jitsu, ask Ryan or Dave if you can be an instructor. So it's a great program to get into. And if you don't have a passion to teach, though, don't worry about it. Just do jiu-jitsu.
All